Hi, I'm Sarah Niemann. I'm a writer and an editor, but I'm also a photographer. I am a naturalist by background, but I've always enjoyed taking pictures. And I used to find that I would take my little camera and go out and take some pictures, and I could never quite capture what I could see with my eye. So I went away and learned a bit more about how to do it properly, and now I just absolutely love it. So let's get the serious bit out the way first. Make sure that you keep yourself safe. You'll be amazed in the heat of the moment when you've seen something really great, how easy it is to lean just that bit further, take another step back. So try to keep in mind where you are and make sure you keep yourself safe. Don't ever trespass to take a photograph. Really, you shouldn't need to. There's so much that you can photograph without trespassing. And do be respectful about people, particularly children. People don't like having a camera shoved in their face. And if you're going to put your pictures on Instagram or Facebook or whatever, think about whether people are going to mind, and particularly with putting pictures of children. And finally, if you're taking a picture of an animal or a bird, just try to think about not harassing it. Just take a step back and give it a bit of room. So today's a lovely sunny day, which is really nice, but actually it can make life difficult for photographers. You have to look out for things like really strong shadows. So if, for example, it was cloudy today and we didn't have any shadows, that's great because it's a really good day for photographing flowers, for example. But what if it's raining? If you take a look in the water, you can see some great reflections. So if it's raining, why not go out and play with that instead? And if it's foggy, everything goes grey and dull, but so what? It's colours, if you find them, really look fantastic against the contrast of the fog. So there is actually never weather where you can't go out and take a good picture. So when you've got your subject that you want to take a photograph of, think about what's in the foreground. Make sure there's nothing sticking up in the way or getting distracting in the foreground. And make sure there's nothing sticking up at the back as well. So you don't want a telegraph pole coming out of somebody's head, that kind of thing. But also think about the way you put something into the picture. So you don't have to plonk your subject right in the middle. It can actually be more interesting if you try moving around where you put it. And a classic trick to use is what's called the rule of thirds. So if you imagine what you're looking at, sliced up into thirds that way and sliced up into thirds that way, find the spot where the thirds cross in the corners and try putting your subject there for a change and seeing if you like it. So for example, this water lily here, I could plonk it right in the middle, or I could put it over to one side and let a little bit more of the surroundings show and see how I feel about that. So it's worth looking at different angles. So this lovely little scarlet pimpernel here, rather than stand over it and point your camera down at it, get down and have a look at it at its own eye level. There we go. Much better. I'd say just grab your camera, get out there, start taking lots of pictures and really enjoy it.